Thank you. We are, I don't know if you noticed, with the pandemic and whatnot, this specific group in the last 3 years, we went virtual like most people did. Last year we made our first return back to the stage. I believe we only had about 40 musicians. Mass social distance up on stage, and here we are. A year later, we now are up to 56 musicians in the Thunder River Symphony. Okay, before we get into our next selection with the choir here, inside all your programs, I'm going to be very, very strict about this. This little piece of paper it's more than just a piece of paper. I'm also the music director out in the Jewel School District as well. My wife, right here, Angela, is the director for the Astoria School District. Jack, raise your hand. Jackson, we got Jackson from, I believe, Napa, is that correct? We've got Seaside represented. Am I missing anybody from one of those schools? Okay, we have Brian also. I know we have Brian over at Ocean School District for Elementary Music. Music reaches all sorts of people, young and old. And when I say old, you know I'm not joking about that. this piece of paper. It is about the organization, the Clever River Symphony. But on the right-hand side, I said give the gift of music. If you don't know somebody to hand this off to, my wife was on a radio show last night, and within 2 hours we had a musician in the community who was a viola player. I don't know if Carson is here today, but Carson reached out to us and said, you know, what if? And so instead of a what if, he did, I'm going to do this. And so I'm going to encourage you, find someone who might find some joy, whether helping us out, whether singing, whether he's doing this also, and take part in the community ensembles that we have out here on the coast. We greatly appreciate it here. Okay, our next selection. Are you guys ready for this? Okay. Summer in My Memory. Mm-hmm.
minutes of repeat. So this is Carol as well. Could I please have a IB class to record the IB class?
Let me record the what?
The IB class.
It was a horrible situation. Tears all over the audience here when she composed that piece and performed it. She's back here today, and she has composed another piece. She's going to Western Oregon University, composition. Her next piece that she is going to conduct herself, very excited for her to do so, is titled Waking from Yesterday. Would you please give a round of applause for Isabella Morrill.
This is kind of a special moment for me because this group, I mean, that was the first composition I ever composed and heard live 3 years ago, so that was super special. Now it's like my first time conducting. It's just like such an honor to play, to have played with these musicians and to now just like experience one of my creations with them. And just like a little bit about this piece, it's called Waking from Yesterday, and I composed it about 2 years ago. And if any of you are artists, I'm sure you understand the feeling of like looking back on something you once created and you're like, wow, I was a totally different person in both character and skill, and maybe I would do things differently if I had, you know, written that or created that now. But it's really cool because it's like a time capsule of who you once were, and so it's kind of special. So like when I hear this piece, it takes me back to a time of like a lot of transition in my life. Like COVID is going on and I'd ended high school and was starting college. Studying composition, which has been like a dream, but I was also just like saying bye to a lot of friends and experiencing some loss in just like my personal life. So yeah, I don't know. This was like a piece of just like learning how to wake up and like live each day as its own day and not try to like hold on to things from the past. So I guess like the programmatic idea is just, you know, spending a day like it just starts out like stressful, and then like you sleep and you wake up and it's just like have relief. So I hope you enjoyed your cooking yesterday.
Thank you.
give her one more round of applause. It's so much. We're going to have one more selection here before we take a little intermission here. I've been saying at all my concerts recently that I'm enjoying, surrender yourself to the music. It's easy to get caught up in the days, whatever it may be, whether it's stuff going on every single day, something just happened. But if you're in the audience, sit back, relax. When she's performing that piece, and when I say performing, she literally is performing the piece for the orchestra. I can't say what's going on in these individuals' heads, or what's going on in your head, but I know for me I'm having something very reminiscent, something very storytelling in my head going through that process. We're going to transition into a piece called Somerset Overture. That would be Carol's favorite piece of all time. very fun selection, very upbeat. Once again, I'm going to say surrender yourself to music. Enjoy it. Let it take you places and be open to that. Let it take you places here. So thank you. In about 15 or so minutes here. That time we're going to get the choir all ready to go for the second half and get the musicians going also. I was going to mention, if you're live streaming this, or if anyone wants to catch a live stream, it's on Astoria Kids Got Talent on Facebook. So if there's any It's on YouTube, so if anyone's interested, the story your kids got talent. It's on YouTube. Is that good? Okay. Awesome. Let's take about 15 minutes and we'll be back here. Thank you, guys. Thank you.
Our next selection is from the Seaside Chamber Choir. This piece titled "Wind Back Through Heart" is a memory of Kyle Rager, who was the former band director for Seaside High School, and he was there for 1 year, if I'm correct, before an accident on Highway 26, which took his life, not even a year ago. So I do know Seaside, you have gone through a lot in the last year, going through this choir, dedicating this piece to Kyle, very much so here. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
lection, this next lection, I'm going to speak a little bit more about toward the very last part of the concert here, but at this moment, would you please welcome one of our newest trombone players, an incredible asset to the community, Mr. Jim Achilles.
Goodbye, remember me. Don't let it make you cry. Forever, if I'm far away, I hold you in my arms. I sing a secret song to you each night we are apart. Remember me. Though I have to travel far, remember me. Each time you hear a sad guitar, know that I'm with you the only way that I can be, until you're in my arms again. Remember me.
Jim is a real a treasure for this community, very much so. Thank you, Jim. Okay, we're gonna have a little bit of fun here. If you feel like dancing in the hallways or aisleways, whatever you want to call it, go for it. I'm gonna perform for you a jazzy version of Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. If you're in the percussion section, you don't have a choice. Okay, thank you. Before we get to our final selection, I would mention Jim Achilles. He's still right there. The Jim waved just for more stand up here. So there's a gentleman up there, I think Don Anderson. Don, are you up here still? He's waving his hand. He's doing some video photography up there. Last year, Don was outside of the Liberty Theater out in the back, in the front there, excuse me. And there's a gentleman playing. I don't remember what it was. Do you remember what you were playing?
French horn.
You were playing French horn at the time?
Yeah.
Okay, so there's a gentleman playing French horn. And Don comes running to me after the end of the concert and goes, "Corey, Corey." I'm like, "Don, I'm right here." Don said there's a gentleman outside who's interested, just was wandering around playing music for everybody, just for a festive mood, and heard the symphony, came on in. Remember I said one person can change the world? If you follow me before, I'll say one person can change the world. Jim, I'm serious when I say this. You bring a whole different environment to this ensemble, you really do. And it's that level that we keep raising and keep rising. And throughout every single one of you guys in here, we keep doing that. We keep bringing more, we keep bringing more, and we're excited to do so. And for us, having you here is our biggest thing in the world. So great. Wait a minute. No, you can have a pause, that's great. So in a moment, I want to hear you sing. Wait a minute. Oh, wait. Oh, Santa Claus! Oh, Merry Christmas! I'm so happy to be here. Oh my gosh, look at this. Oh. I have to tell you just a quick story about Corey when he was growing up. I've seen several of you, and I have stories about all of you. But when Corey was about this tall in his neighborhood, he would line up all the dogs and the cats, and he would try and get them to sing, and he would try and get, well, the instruments were not there yet, quite for him. But the stories I have, oh my gosh, the things that have occurred at the North Pole this last year, oh my gosh. And you've all done so well getting through that whole COVID thing. We went out, we played in the snow, we had sled races, we had competition with hot chocolate, and along with the sled races, if you came to the North Pole, our toy factory, one room, is about the size of this theater. It's amazing the things that we can do there. And yes, you are all on my good list. So I know some of you have got some coal in the last couple of years, but don't worry. Now, are we going to sing some songs?
We're going to sing. And when we sing, again, for me, my expectations, I'm a teacher, so this is my expectations is big and loud, full, and if you can't sing, sing louder. So if you wouldn't mind standing, we're going to have fun. We're going to sing the night away over the holiday sing-along. Santa's going to lead
you
along.
You bet. Let's do it, Corey.
Here we go. make it its way down. I'm going to be ready for photo ops. Everyone have a happy holidays and please prosperous New Year's. Thank you very much.